Since Repair Clinic encourages you to perform this procedure safely, a warning icon will appear when you should use caution. Many Frigidaire Laundry Center repairs will require some disassembly of the appliance. These are the tools you'll need to fully disassemble and reassemble the laundry center. Before you begin, unplug the power cord and shut off the incoming water supply. Have an assistant help you to move the appliance away from the wall or out of the closet. To fully access the rear of the appliance, detach the venting from the dryer and remove the hot and cold water supply lines from the inlet valve. Be prepared for some water to spill. Remove the end of the drain hose from the standpipe or laundry tub. To uninstall the dryer drum, first use the number 2 square drive bit to unthread the two screws, securing the dryer belt access panel. Set the panel aside. Move the idler arm to the left so you can detach the belt from the motor pulley and idler pulley. Next, unthread the four screws securing the rear of the top panel. This will make it easier to remove the drum. Moving to the front of the appliance, use the number 2 square drive bit or the Phillips head screwdriver to unthread the two screws securing the dryer's lower access panel. Pull the panel up to remove. Next, unthread the two mounting screws securing the control panel. Pull the panel down to detach. Release the wires from the retaining clip and move the panel out of the way. Disconnect the dryer door switch wire connector. Next, unthread the upper left screw securing the inner access panel. This will make it easier to fully remove the front panel and lint filter duct assembly. Now use the Phillips head screwdriver to unthread the two lower screws securing the front panel. Unthread the four upper screws along the top of the cabinet. With all of the screws unthreaded, you can fully remove the front panel and lint filter duct assembly. Now unthread the screw to remove the drum stop. You can now lift the rear of the drum up to detach the bearing from the support. Then carefully remove the drum from the cabinet. To reinstall the drum, first loop the belt around the drum with its groove side facing inward. Now reposition the drum in the cabinet, making sure the rear bearing is inserted into the bearing support. Reposition the drum stop and thread the screw to secure. Reinstall the front panel by positioning the lower portion of the lint filter duct behind the inner access panel, as you align the front panel mounting pins with the holes in the cabinet frame. rethread the four upper screws. It will be easier to replace the two middle screws first. Rethread the two lower screws. Rethread the upper left screw to fully secure the inner access panel. Reconnect the door switch wire connector. Secure the control panel wires in the retaining clip, then reposition the panel. Replace the mounting screws. Realign the access panel and secure it with the screws. Returning to the rear of the appliance, confirm the top panel and frame are aligned, then rethread the four screws to secure. Loop the drum belt onto the idler and motor pulleys in a zigzag formation. Rotate the drum to help fully align the belt. Reinstall the access panel by inserting the tabs into the slots first, then rethread the screws. If you need to remove the washer's main top, use the putty knife to release the two retaining clips securing the top. Lift up the top and disconnect the lid lock assembly wire connector. You can now fully remove the main top. To remove the washer's front panel, have an assistant help you to lift and support the front of the appliance. Use the Phillips head screwdriver to unthread the two screws, securing the washer's front panel to the base. With the screws unthreaded, remove the support. Then push the panel down to fully remove. To fully uninstall the washer's tub assembly, first detach all four suspension rod springs from the tub cover. Moving to the rear of the appliance, use the 5/16 inch nut driver to unthread the two screws, securing the main control board mounting plate to the rear panel. Use the large flathead screwdriver to help pry the plate free and pull the control board housing out. Disconnect the wire connector for the tub components. Unhook the wires from the clips, then cut the zip tie retainer to fully release the wires. Now feed the wires and connector through the hole in the dryer support panel. Reposition the main control board housing and snap the mounting plate into place. From the front of the cabinet, use the 5/16 inch wrench to unthread the screw to release the grounding wire from the frame. Now carefully tip the appliance back so it rests on its rear panel. Place the 2x4 piece of wood under the tub to support it. Move the tub towards the top of the cabinet to provide enough slack to remove the suspension rod support caps. Be careful not to damage the out-of-balance lever. Now shift each rod up, then push down on the caps to detach. Rotate and twist the caps to fully remove. Cut the zip tie retainer securing the air pressure hose to the right front rod. Remove all four rods by sliding them out through the bottom of the outer tub. Use the pliers to release the spring clamp so you can detach the drain hose from the drain pump. We recommend wrapping a towel around the hose to prevent damage. Detach the air pressure hose from the air chamber. Being careful not to damage the out-of-balance lever, gently remove the tub assembly through the bottom of the cabinet. To reinstall the tub assembly, carefully maneuver it through the bottom of the cabinet until the top of the tub rests near the top support. Reattach the air pressure hose to the chamber. Attach the drain hose to the pump and secure it with the spring clamp. Replace all four suspension rods by holding the springs up against the rods as you slide them through the holes in the outer tub. Insert the top of each rod through the hole in the support. Replace the support cap by first sliding it over the end of the rod, then rotate the cap to align the end of the rod with the long slot, and you can snap the cap into place. Use a new zip tie to secure the air pressure hose to the front right rod. Move the out-of-balance lever out of the way and shift the tub back down toward the base. Remove the 2x4 wood support. Return the laundry center to its upright position. Continue the reassembly by threading the screw to secure the grounding wire to the frame. Returning to the rear of the appliance, pry the main control board housing plate away from the rear panel and pull the housing out. Feed the wires and connector for the tub components through the hole in the dryer support panel. Connect the wire connector to the board. Then secure the wires under the clips. Use a new zip tie to secure the wires to the retainer. Reinstall the control board and housing by snapping the plate into place in the rear panel. Then rethread the screws. Returning to the front of the cabinet, attach the four suspension rod springs to the tub cover mounting posts. Reinstall the front panel by aligning the tabs on the panel with the slots in the frame. Then lift the panel up until the top edge aligns with the top of the frame. Support the front of the appliance, then replace the two lower screws to secure the panel. Remove the support. Reinstall the washer's main top by first reconnecting the lid lock wire connector. Secure the wire in the retaining clip. Now slide the rear of the main top under the rear retaining clips. Then realign the main top and push down to snap it into position. With the reassembly complete, reinsert the drain hose into the standpipe or hook it onto the edge of the tub. Reattach the hot and cold water supply lines to the inlet valve ports. Reattach the venting and move the appliance back against the wall or into the closet. Turn the water supply back on. Plug the power cord back in. And your laundry center should be ready for use.